Hello and welcome to this video. Today I want to talk with you about the Leica power functions servo motor, about the possibilities, why it even exists, and if it's necessary for powered up and control plus models. But first, let's get to the reason for its existence. Normal motors can drive forwards or they can drive backwards. They can turn in one direction. In that case, a vehicle would drive forwards, or they can turn into the other direction. In that case, the vehicle would drive backwards. And there's no limit on the angle. It can drive as far as it wants, or as long as you give the signal to drive. So there are no limits on how far it should move. But that's different for the steering. Here, you have a fixed angle. You can move to the center. You can move a bit into one direction, and you can move a bit into the other direction. You can move to the positions in between, but there are fixed maximum positions that you can't exceed. So in this case, you can't move longer. There's a stop. There's basically a limit on how far you can move. For driving, you can move as far as you want. And for steering, you can only move for a given amount of positions or for a given angle. And that's the reason why we need servo motors. You can use normal motors to drive and they work just fine. But for steering, you need some kind of motor that can control the position. And that's this motor. It has a mark for the zero position. So there are two dots on the motor and they should be more or less on the same point for the initial position. And then you can connect the power functions plug to a power functions battery box. You can't use the 9-volt adapter cable as power source. Normally, you would use a receiver to connect it to the battery box. But in my case, for the demonstration, I will use this normal rechargeable battery box. And you saw that the motor already moved when I turned it on. And now I can change the position of the style. This switch has 7 positions per direction, and that's normal for power functions. You can also use the train motor and the receiver to get these 7 positions per direction, but only the rechargeable battery box has them directly on the box. And now I can move the switch a bit, and the motor will move a bit. So we have several positions for the motor up to 90 degrees. The same applies into the other direction. Here we can select a position of up to 90 degrees. You won't have this precise control of the position with the normal power functions remote, so you only have 3 positions, the 2 maximum positions and the 0 position. So that's how this servo motor works. In the past few months, Chinese motors became more popular. This one is by Kada. And I just want to give you a small note regarding the servo motors, because all that I tested myself have a limitation in comparison to the Lego motor. You saw I moved this switch for one position and it moved to the maximum position and it stays there. So this one has only 3 positions, although that's not entirely true. In the other direction, it has more positions, but they really don't make sense. I'm not sure why they exist. Only the maximum both positions and the 0 position make sense for this motor. So these motors are cheaper. They are still available. This one doesn't get made anymore, and the aftermarket prices skyrocket. But this has its own limitations, or most of the Chinese motors have limitations. They only have 3 positions instead of 15. But now let's get to the reason, or to the solution that powered up uses. I got a powered up hub and a powered up motor. This is the hub used in control plus models and the motor used in control plus models. the large motor, and I've got the powered up app with a program. It's a pretty simple program. I have a slider in the gamepad interface, and that's the input for the position of the motor. There are different motor blocks for different behaviors. So this motor can be used as a normal motor to drive forwards or backwards, but it also includes a rotation sensor, so it can be used as a servo motor. It needs an initial calibration to get to the maximum positions, but then it can read its own position and it can control the position. And you can see that I can move it, and it has many positions in between. Depending on the angle and on the software implementation, it can even have many more positions than the powered up motor, but that depends on the implementation. So in this case, it has more than 7 positions per direction. It gets really close to analog controls. And that's a huge advantage of the powered up system. You don't need these special servo motors anymore. Most of the powered up motors have included rotation sensors, and they can be used as servo motors just fine. And again, they have a position sensor or rotation sensor. They can be used for many other things, not just for servo or for normal driving. They can also be used for a gearbox and other stuff. But that was it for this video. Thanks for watching. Feel free to ask me questions if you've got any regarding servo motors or power functions or powered up or stuff like that in the comments. You can also ask me all other questions if you want me to explain something. I already made a video on pneumatics. You can find it here in the top in the info card. But thanks for now. See you in the next video, and bye.